Other interesting cultural news, you have Candace Owens for Steven Crowder 2.0, perhaps? Now, this comes after a former co-host at Louder Crowder's Jared Monroe did a GoFundMe to apparently fight an NDA he signed. There's a lot of people covering this topic, and it looks like I don't have enough information or direct information either way. I mean, NDAs are pretty common. I work in IT, so there's very things I do without getting an NDA when it comes to an end user or working with a business. So it's one of those things where it's pretty common for most businesses. Same with non-competes, though courts, depending on the industry, are kind of moving away in favor of non-competes, but also those are also pretty common. And Candace Owens caught wind that Jared Monroe is trying to raise money for his legal fight against his former employer, Steven Crowder, Lyra Crowder. And Candace says, quote, "Everything Jared Monroe is saying is true, and he is one of many people who has been enduring this legal abuse for years. Crowder's ex-wife and family and virtually all of his former employees, including Dave Landau, should similarly find the courage to speak out," unquote. And Candace went viral, to say the least. She got 1.1 million views, but only 9.3 thousand likes earlier this week. And the numbers had time to brew. All these statistics I wrote down 24 hours after she originally posted it. So it's not like it was 2 seconds after she posted it. I mean, that actually might be the one of the lowest like ratios since, well, nothing's worse than Chris Christie's social media. We covered that. That was a hilarious phenomenon in which we dubbed it the Chris Christie effect. He actually had instances where Chris Christie would tweet something and he'd have zero positive responses, which is almost mathematically impossible, presumably because he has family, friends, allegedly a campaign staff when he was running for the Republican nominee. And yet there are two times where he had zero positive comments. Now here, as this has become kind of a political or cultural issue in the Republican or Conservative Party or, you know, social media spheres and media companies, I suspect the comments will probably be 50-50, split in terms of who's supporting who, you know, supporting Candace Owens versus Steven Crowder. But maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it's 100% ratio. Set in the comments and find out. Now, one of the first ones is Candace replying to her own comment. She says, quote, "I will have Hillary Crowder on my new show, going to reach out and see if I can get her," unquote, getting 3.6 thousand likes, which I was going to say, that's Steven Crowder's former wife he's going through a divorce with. And again, I just read it on, I'm not sure if Gerald posted it, but on social media it was found that she's getting about $24,000 a month in alimony, apparently. I should say allegedly, I just saw it on X Twitter. But yeah, $24,000 per month. Dear God. Now granted, they do have two children together, but that is a pretty penny to say the least. Well, I should clarify, a vintage penny, modern pennies are just 99.99% zinc, also known as garbage. They're just copper plated, which is perhaps a apt metaphor for US currency. Partially digress. You also have Nice Guy P saying, quote, "This is a bad path to go down. I'm a big fan, but I don't think this is a wise decision. There are glaring issues with this. If there is no consideration to sign an NDA, it's unenforceable, period. End of story. NDAs and non-competes are a basic part of any employment." Well, he goes on for a paragraph here, but he got a lot of views for this, so I'll continue the whole thing. So he says, part of any employment, as far as waivers of claim, quote, "Even as a lawyer, I naively trusted my ex-employer and let him depart without an NDA or waiver of claim. A few months later, the moment the severance ended, my name was being smeared, my clients were being poached, and this person sued my company for an ownership stake, a complete frivolous lawsuit. Had I not been a lawyer, I probably would have spent $25,000 to defend it. I filed a counterclaim and got the case to go away for $0 at the mediation phase after a neutral third party saw through the scheme that's going on. This guy's intentions are transparent. When a disgruntled ex-employee starts citing, quote, mental health and his, quote, pregnant wife, allowing God to lead him and free speech, there's a good indication he doesn't have any real facts or real evidence. He's playing on your emotions. I thought you were one of the leading proponents of sounding an alarm on people manipulating others with so-called emotion. I really hope you don't go down the same path with your departure from Daily Wire, Candace. This reeks of weakness and victimhood. I thought that was everything you were against. Considering the entire Crowder beef originated from his criticism of the Daily Wire, it doesn't make any sense for you to kick up this old dirt. I see you as a journalist, a storyteller, and a leader, not as a gossip tabloid blogger. Like I said, I'm a huge fan. I think very highly of you. I hate how you've been treated, but going down this rabbit hole is only going to derail your ascent to being one of the most influential voices of our country, unquote. Quite a few words to say at least, but that did get 313 likes, which is, again, one of the top responses to Candace Owens. You also have Tim the Toolman saying, quote, hey, tune in tomorrow, Candace, maybe you'll learn something, unquote, getting 656 likes, which, spoiler alert, they did. If you tuned in, you did. They show that, you know, apparently Jared, he's been trying to sue the company for quite some time and breaking the NDA, and apparently he's been kicking up the dirt or bringing up this thing. Because again, the employment ceased about 6 years ago. It's quite some time. And apparently he's also teaming up with Steven Zax, and there's a lot of unusual things happening, to say the least. You also have the center view saying we love Steven Crowder, getting 40 likes. Stephen Hasty said, quote, excited for what is next for you, Candace, getting 48 likes. You have Joy Gaskin saying, quote, anyone notice the title of Jared's video is I Don't Want to Do This, titled after the video Crowder made to expose Big Con, unquote, getting 59 likes. You have Midwest Guy 88 saying, quote, so many conservative pundits all going down the same time during the election season, not suspicious at all, unquote, getting 91 likes. Well, actually, no. 92 likes. Well, spoiler alert, that one, last one was for me. But yeah, there's a lot of drama in conservative media when, in terms of the timing, probably the worst timing for them to not be united, especially considering the election this year, which is going to be paramount for many things and many reasons. You also have, well, if I could use the screen properly, you have Stephen Haas official saying, quote, a simple solution to this is if you want a job at a company and they're trying to make you sign an NDA, don't sign it and don't take the job. It's literally that simple. If they come to you and they tell you to sign an NDA before you quit or they let you go, don't sign it. It's literally that simple. I'm getting 56 likes. Scrolling back, you got a couple more. You have Owen Benjamin saying, quote, I told people all about it and was called jealous because apparently I secretly wanted to wear dresses and own the left like Crowder. The main reason I went so hard at Crowder was that he was doing to people who couldn't talk. What he was doing to people who couldn't talk. And his dumb baby boomer fans called me schizophrenic. Good to see this coming out, unquote. I got 326 likes. Let's see here. Julu Vibes says, quote, always got bad vibes from Crowder. Never enjoyed his content. Unquote, getting 17 likes. Amber Champagne says, quote, this is a year of eye-opening circumstances everywhere, getting, unquote, getting 17 likes. Woke Golden Boy says, quote, Landau went way in depth months ago with Michael Malice. Am I the only one watching You're Welcome, unquote? Getting 19 likes, which that is the show program that Michael Malice hosts. Interesting name for a show. It's called You're Welcome. Let's see. MiddleMaga.com says, quote, I can't believe you're still going at Crowder after getting fired from the Daily Wire. Just leave the Crowder stuff alone. You're on a good roll. Unquote, getting 10 likes, which, again, they've had verbal sparring sessions for years. They've gone back and forth on social media. Candace covers Steven a lot, to say the least. Do a couple more here. You have Misinformation saying, quote, this is insufferably boring. Why are we supposed to care about him? Unquote, getting 7 likes. Well, interestingly enough, and of course, you know, NX Twitter, Crowder is trending, as the youth might say, with this being one of the main topics. Now, kind of curious to see what his fundraising has got to when it comes to... He even bought the domain freejaredmonroe.com. So it looks like Jared has raised $76,456 of his $100,000 goal. How quickly? Created in 2 days? Jeez Louise. That is a pretty penny to say the least. Let's see here. And of course, his video on X Twitter got 6.7 million views, but only 17,000 likes, which is pitifully. I mean, that ratio is low to say the least. I mean, very low. Maybe we'll cover that a little bit later. But looks like in terms of the comments specifically on Candace's take on the situation, looks to be around 60-40 split supporting Candace. But granted, a wise man once said sunlight is the best disinfectant. We'll see how much of this information is actually made available to the public. And we'll see, you know, at the end of the day, what side are people going to choose. But let me know. I mean, seems to be an interesting situation. As always, it'd be fascinating to hear what you have to say. Thank you, everyone, for taking the time to tune in. Again, I'm trying to get to 4,000 subscribers by the end of the month, so if you could click that button, I'd greatly appreciate it. Also, leave a thumbs up, thumbs down, or comment. It's a great way to give me some additional feedback, letting me know how I can make the show better and better. Lastly, don't forget to take the time to tell your family, tell your friends, tell your coworkers, heck, tell your enemies, tell anyone and everyone. Just stay safe, fight the good fight.